A new report says when it comes to your heart, you might need to treat what's happening in your head.
Liz Bonas joins us to explain the connection. Liz.
Hey guys, good afternoon to you once again. Good afternoon to you. We've known for a while that what is good for the heart is good for the head, meaning what you do to reduce your heart problems, such as eating better, exercising more, lowering blood pressure and cholesterol, can all help reduce brain diseases such as Alzheimer's disease and depression. Now, a new report, which is part of a summary report from or on the heart from Consumer Reports on Health, says it also works the other way around. It says people with depression are not only more likely to have poor diet and exercise habits, which can lead to heart disease, but it appears if you don't treat the depression, you raise the risk for inflammation in the body, which is a silent risk factor for having a heart attack. Therapists at the Lindner Center of Hope that we talked to treat mental health concerns such as depression. We asked them if you need treatment for a mental health problem or something like depression, what do they want us to know?
A couple of things. I think one, you're not alone. A lot of people have had these similar symptoms. I think that's why a lot of people are quiet. They feel like it sort of makes them odd or something's wrong with them because they're experiencing that. You're not alone. But two, it doesn't have to stay this way. Recovery is possible. You just need to talk about it and get services, and you can be living better.
Don't you love that? You don't have to stay there. So what they're saying is if you treat the body and we don't get the mind engaged, we probably can't shift everything from the hormones that may attack your heart back into balance. Yeah. And we are delicate beings, fearfully and wonderfully made, and we have to have everything in balance.
I believe that the mind affects so many other
yes.
things.
Yes, but to be able to measure it now and yeah. say there's like a blood test called CR3 and it can measure inflammation, and they notice when people have mental health concerns such as depression, CR3 goes up and they think it's the inflammation. So what's happening in your head is influencing your heart. It's just really interesting to see it all work together.
Wow.
Yeah.
So